I feel like, didn't we hear this?
I think I've heard it. It's probably in the trailer.
That was good. I like the thing.
Step it again.
Yeah. Wait. So Mr. Morale and Big Stepper. I thought like Mr. Morale is the first side and then Big Steppers is the name of the second side. But steps were all, like throughout the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Uh-huh. So I guess my theory was wrong. Track 11, right? Or track 12 at this point.
11. Yeah, 11.
Track 11, Crown. I can't please everybody. No, I can't please everybody. Wait. Real nice, it's like a top movie. Yeah. I think it's also because the recording is so high quality with like all the best microphones, all the best engineers that you can get. Sounds so rich. You're covering your face. It's funny looking footage. It's not structurally. Yeah.
See my hand poking out behind my head.
Silent Hill, there's a feature. It's the best feature. I'm gonna add it
out. Drake?
Drake is not the best feature anymore.
Drake is not on the Kendrick album. It's never gonna happen again.
Well, never say never. We'll see.
Be quiet. I'm stressed out. Stressed out. Bitch, you talk too much. You make a bit popular. I mean, it's hard enough. Yeah. What'd you do to the poor guy? He has no chin.
What was the name of the album again? Mr.
Morale?
Mr. Morale, yeah. Mr. Morale. We need to put his last few tracks. To say this. Catch me a body, I put that on anybody but my mama. She's showing the pattern for certain. I think it's white panties and minimal condoms. Violin, so beautiful. My uncle would tell me the shit.
Gun ready, got the 30 in a press. It's an interlude or a song, bro?
Baby Kim does the best interludes though. You know better. Scapegoats. You know better than anyone else.
Okay. I got this shit bragging in 4 days, 4 hours. Still going. 2 hours. An interlude is apparently 3,000 years long. I'm not complaining, but that shit is not an interlude, bro. How long was it?
It was almost 10 minutes. That's
not an interlude. It's a whole ass song, bro. Call it Baby Kim song.
Yeah, Baby Kim definitely the most welcome addition from 2021.
Agreed.
To our music lives. Save year. Save year.
So we have Save the Interlude, now it's Save Year. So I'm assuming Baby Kim's gonna be on the game.
Yes.
Bro, what's the telling? You're supposed to be surprised.
And there's you, look, and your friend, Drew.
Shout out Headband Andy.
They can't hear you too far.
Shout out Headband Andy!
Auntie Diaries.
Feature or not?
No. No.
This is how we conceptualize human beings.
Like this?
Yeah, exactly like that.
Monty is a man now. Bunch of men is good old holding hands down, tipping the avenues on the street lights made his, thinking I won't be a bad bitch when I get big. That's when you looked at me and smiled, said I thank you. The day I chose humanity over religion. My family got close, it was all forgiven. We can say it together, but only if you let a white girl say nigga.
Okay. Alright. when it comes to the first sound, when we were listening to the first disc, I was thinking, well, this man is rapping in the first disc for sure. I mean, he's a rapper, but he's trying R&B and soul. On the second disc, I was thinking, I mean, apart from the joke I made, maybe he will start rapping on sort of like a disco the tracks, because like that's the only thing he hasn't done yet. This kind of like comes close to that. I think like it's more upbeat. Like, when it comes to the lyrics, I kind of, sometimes I was like zoning out, just like bobbing my head, but when I was like tuning in, so the main points are, so his aunt she changed the gender,
mm-hmm.
and then his cousin followed sort of her footstep, I mean their footstep.
Yeah, but the other way, so from right. male to female, except his cousin actually did it. Surgically,
right?
His aunt did not do it surgically. His aunt was just, and then he was talking about how people were jealous of the aunt because he was more successful than everyone else and was getting more girls than everyone else, and they all didn't like him for that reason. And then moving on to the cousin, who was talking about how like his preacher or pastor or whatever was saying how he's like the what's wrong with the world because he changed his gender, and then. His family was like, oh, we didn't see it coming. And he's talking about how people like that, people who have those things, are in, especially in cultures or families that don't really accept it, build a wall, like they don't show it, stuff like that. It was cool, though. I don't know how it's going to go out that he's saying the F slur like that.
Well, I mean...
I get it in context. I'm definitely not going to be able to sing along to that. But, I get it. But I don't know how it's gonna go. Just knowing the internet, we'll see. And the end was the end. I don't know about the end.
I didn't really catch it, so I don't know. Well, I did something about like.
He said, "Let's all say it together, the F slur, but only if you let a white girl say the N word." But who is saying that? From whose point of view is that? Is that from Kendrick's point of view,
maybe,
or is
that
from the cousin, like somebody else's point of view?
I just remembered like. Remember how, I mean, I don't know if you know the story, but in Kendrick's concert, there's a white girl and saying N-word.
I guess that could
maybe
be.
Maybe that could be a reference, kind of, but I'm not really sure. What is he trying to say with that anyway?
Right. I don't know about that. We're going to have to look into that part. But it was cool. Good song. I like how he's talking about things like this.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how his little... fucking diehard fans are gonna kind of feel about it, but
I have
little pussy fucking bitch ass keyboard warrior fans on Twitter. Kendrick number one, Kendrick.
Keyboard warriors. No, but I've heard the F word before, like casual like that. So I don't think it's like a.
But yeah, now it is though. He was saying they used to say it in middle school because they didn't know better.
Right. Okay.
But I don't know what I get it until the last part. The last part, I'm a little confused. Who was saying that? Maybe I think I missed the beginning where it was like set up.
Okay,
it was a good song.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I like it too. Mr. Morale.
Okay, I saw the feature. It's no one I know. So that's fine.
Yeah. Tana Leon. I don't know. Or him.
Tana Mongo.
Or them. Tana Mongo. Don't mention that name in this house.
It was one of the worst performances I've seen in my life.
Okay.
Oh, man.
Damn, that's hard. Really hard. Oh, that feature is so nice too. This guy, he sounds like Nelly from Hot in Here.
Nelly from Hot in Here?
I mean, like, that sounds
Nelly, man.
I mean, exactly that song, though. Like, yeah, it's sounding different. Yeah, that was a great song.
I love that one. That was dope.
Yeah, and maybe this is the last track, I lost count, but Mother, I Sober, featuring somebody.
You want to see it? Go look. I haven't heard of them until like 2 weeks ago, and that's when they're everywhere.
Is it newer band?
Newer relevant, I think. Your relevancy. I don't know how old. I'm like, I barely know anything. I just know that I've heard of it a couple of times.
I haven't heard of that name before.
I went to a Quickly concert with my friend, and he covered a song. Have you heard of Portishead?
I was like, no. I was never drunk. Never. You broke a generational curse. Say thank you, Dad.
Thank you, Daddy.
That's his daughter, I'm guessing.
I think so. I think it maybe appeared in the album already.
That song?
Yeah, I wish it was a whole song like that. That's 15 seconds. Did you catch the idea of the song?
Wait, it's talking about how he... I don't... See, like, I feel like I don't know... if he's speaking from his own perspective here or from somebody else's, but he's talked about how whoever's perspective it is, they were abused as a child. I don't know if I feel like it's sexually abused by family members, and how I don't want to speak on this that much because I'm no expert, obviously, but just from what I heard in a lot of the Black culture that he's talking about, it's not uncommon to be abused by your own family.
Right.
In that way. He's talking about how every other rapper has some kind of sexual abuse history that they're trying to hide. And it's just a generational curse that at the end, supposedly he has broken.
Right.
By being, and like a lot of misogyny, a lot of just like negative things in that culture. But I mean, obviously, I don't know. So I'm speaking from what he said, not from, you know.
I'm not being an expert or anything, but...
Definitely a powerful song. I feel like this album is very his most artistic, powerful album in terms of things other than what To Pimp a Butterfly already addressed.
Mm.
In terms of things that maybe most people have never even addressed.
Mm.
No one has. I don't think any rapper has ever talked about this, or like.
I haven't heard about it that much either.
Yeah, but never heard that before.
Maybe, I mean, maybe I'm wrong, but To Pimp a Butterfly, it's more about, like, what do you call it, the streets and, like, the generational, I mean, not generational, like, Black neighborhoods and, like, Black culture in general, and, like, how people progressed, or from past to present, how they lived. I'm talking about African Americans, but... here it's more like family problems, like it's like definitely. Within now it's like
it's more I feel like
that's fine glass.
That's why I wanted. I'm not sure if it's from his perspective or not, but if it's from his perspective, it's very personal.
Mm-hmm.
It's like personal problems instead of like the just like talking about an entire culture. It's more talking about him, his family, what he's been through, the fucking his trauma, his experience, instead of just a general, I mean, obviously everything else has also been his experience, but it's speaking in a more general sense. This has been a lot of I, so it's been about him. If, once again, like, artistically, it's possible that he's not speaking from his own perspective, he's just speaking as I, from, like, the perspective of an entire culture or an entire group of people, but also it could be him. So that's what we have, you have to interpret, I guess, unless he says it, which I don't know, I haven't seen any of it, I don't know if he's had press or anything, I don't think he has, but yeah, it's crazy, definitely, yeah, interesting take, and brave take. Brave to say that shit as a rapper,
and
especially in the culture that we have.
And I kind of noticed a similar thing when you tried to do the same with, like, I mean, not talking about specifically African Americans in your album, but sort of maybe Kendrick may not be talking about himself, but he's talking about, like, from a character, but sort of still addressing the issues that he cares about, and you were doing the same.
And that's kind of where I'm coming from here, where I'm saying, like, into, I don't want to equate myself to Kendrick at all, but, like, in music, it's more, like, freeing to put yourself in the shoes or in a character or, like, in a metaphor rather than just speaking from your own perspective. Because then you can discuss so many more things than just, like, what you personally have done. You can discuss a concept or, like, a whole group of things that you could never have talked about if it was just, you were like, I did this, I did that, I did this, I did that. Yeah. Like, unless you want to lie. But if you can make a concept or a metaphor and, like, encompass it within maybe even a first-person perspective, then you can talk about almost anything you want. So that's why I'm kind of thinking maybe that's what he's doing, but it's also very possible it's his own experience. I wouldn't be surprised. So
okay, and I have a last song, Mirror.
Tell me if there's a feature.
Nope, there's no feature.
Tyler, the Creator.
Oh yeah, instantly his production.
It might even be.
Yeah,
that's exactly what I thought.
That's dope. I mean, I feel like this is, he went, like, all the way to the
radio generic, not generic, like, radio friendly, very, like, accessible side with Damn.
Yeah.
And I feel like here he pulled it all the way back to the other side, which is almost 0% accessible to a general audience. Like, he did not make this for general sales at all. Like, none of this is getting radio play, just because it's Kendrick, of the power of his name, but none of these songs are radio songs. None of these songs are hits. None of these songs are anything that's going to be played outside of a actual rap, a rap enjoyer, or someone who really enjoys hip-hop. None of this is, like, catchy. None of some of it is. One was catchy. The one with Kodak. The one where he's talking about he's a killer, she's a killer. And then the one with Baby Keem. So 3 out of 18.
Well, I can't even remember. I counted more, but, like,
are catchy though.
Yeah, there are, like, fire songs.
I'm not talking about fire. I'm talking about catchy. I'm talking about, like, if you hear that, you're going to be singing that all day.
Oh, well, yeah, maybe.
You don't have that many.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, and it's not a bad thing.
Yeah.
It just means that he's not making a song for a general audience, or an album for a general audience anymore. This album is very much for a very specific audience of people who want to know about the culture of what he's been through, or whoever, like, he's talking about, you know, we already went through it. What he's been through, knew it, the experience of that, people who really appreciate hip-hop for hip-hop, rap for rap, not for any kind of, like, at least vocally musical melodic stuff, more just, like, general rap. Really dope production under that. But yeah, it's very much like his least accessible album, I would say, out of anything he's ever released. Like, there's no album even that he's made that doesn't have a hit on it.
I feel like, in a way, To Pimp a Butterfly is less accessible album than this was.
To Pimp a Butterfly has hits, bro. A
couple.
Yeah, well, where's the hit? Name the hit.
Well, I cannot name it right now because it's not a hit yet.
No, but which song is a hit? Going to be a hit.
I agree with your points, but I'm just saying that as time goes on and people can make certain song that from this album a hit, that you will be viewing that as like differently, but I guess you know that it can hold as a single power. Like, for example, even The Weeknd, Donna Family, first we were talking about the same thing, but Sacrifice is definitely a hit.
Did we say there was? I never didn't say there's no hits on fucking.
It was like fan. I mean, you didn't go like that, but it was like more of a, like we compared After Hours, Blinding Lights, right? Like there are 10 long songs, like singles, good, but Donna Fam was like
throughout the experience. But that's not the same at all, because the entirety of Donna Fam is an accessible album. Song on there, you can have. I mean, those are very traditional, like verse hook songs. This doesn't have that. Mm-hmm. Anytime you take a song or an album and you take away that structure, it becomes less catchy.
Yeah.
And less, like, if some random person were to hear that, they wouldn't be like, yo, let me hear that again. Mm-hmm. But you're saying To Pimp a Butterfly doesn't have hits? King Kunta, All Right, Hood Politics, How many of these songs are
the Blacker the Berry?
Black of the Berry, bro. Like, five literally.
No, but I mean, the whole album, if you listen to it,
no, it's of not course, like, but, for, but there's mainstream. No hit, none. I couldn't name a single song on there that I could be like, that's gonna be the one.
Yeah, I mean, I cannot do it right now, but I think.
I don't think you ever
listen to it.
Until it happens.
I mean, I've heard it, but I cannot. Pinpoint because I don't know the track list yet.
No, I understand, like, but there's not even a song that I can be like that one. Yeah. That was like, this is gonna be on the radio. I can't see any of those songs on the radio. There's no Humble. There's no.
I can't hear DNA yet as well.
Because Humble and DNA were invented to be on radio. Yes.
I mean,
that was the entire purpose of that kind of music. There is no intent. Of giving this any like staying power outside the fact that it's Kendrick Lamar and he's talking about some real shit. There's no intent for this to be a pop hit, to be fucking advertised like that. It literally dropped with no warning in a week.
Yeah.
With no promo. I don't know if he's gonna do promo. This is just.
Yeah. I'm not disagreeing.
Yeah. But that,
I'm not disagreeing at all. And it's not bad that this album is like that at all.
No, of course, absolutely.
I'm just saying that, like, for example, like, in Childish Gambino, for example, the album was called Awaken My Love, right? The single was Redbone, right? When I heard it, to be honest, I didn't like it at all. But then, once people started listening to it, and when it was promoted as single, it's like, well, okay, let me understand why people like it, and then I loved it.
Right.
But
what does that have to do with this?
That people and like we could make like the song they cannot see as singles right now. You could like it. Some songs will be played in the radio for sure, and that those can be picked as singles, and then you will view them as singles. You will view them as like, oh, this can be a separate song.
Well, think about this then. Childish Gambino's last album.
Well, we couldn't pick
any. Name a song that is a hit.
Well, no songs.
Even though it's a fantastic album.
Well, for me, it was forgettable.
I like it a lot. I haven't listened to it in a long time, but I listened to it a lot. God damn. Going back in time, becoming a teenager. I listened to it a lot when it came out, but because that album was so experimental with no structure and no verse hook, you're not going to get hits out of it.
I guess maybe you're right when it comes to that, but especially because maybe that's why it didn't stay with me. I mean, when I reacted to it with my teen, I liked it for sure. But then, after a couple of listens, I kind of stopped listening to it.
Yeah, so it's the same thing. I mean, there's a very big chance, just because it's Kendrick, there will be a song. I mean, the Kodak song, or the Baby Keem, the not the interlude, the actual song.
Yes, yeah,
one of those becomes a hit off the power of Kendrick.
Yeah, and Baby Keem.
No. And also, yeah, or even and Kodak. Kodak is still, for some reason, very popular. I don't really like Kodak like that. He's also weird. but in terms of an album, I feel like there was no intention of it being like that. Mm-hmm. Like, he had no intention of any of these songs being a hit. They're just there right now, and everyone's talking about it like a hit because it's Kendrick.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be a message, or a lot of different messages. I'm still curious as to what the concept of Mr. Morale and the Big Step is.
Yeah,
I still don't know.
Yeah.
I still have no clue.
Yeah.
But it's definitely, it feels like a more adult and mature way of going about making an album.
Mm.
And to the point where he doesn't give a fuck if anybody listens to it.
Yeah.
He doesn't care. Like, he could very well have not even listened, like, released this.
Mm.
Like, this feels like a journal or something.
Mm.
He also said he had writer's block for 2 years and nothing spoke to him.
Mm-hmm.
So something must have inspired him to do this, but it's not. He's made his money. Like, he's already, like, established as one of the best rappers of all time. Like,
yeah.
He doesn't need more, but he's doing it, so.
Yeah. I agree. I mean, I agree with your points, and with that point as well. Again, as I said, I'm not disagreeing. what else do I want to add? This listen was really good. I had a really good time. And I just wanted to say that, in my head, before you started, in my head, I was just thinking, wow, like, he still got it, and he's so amazing. And, like, we, how do you call it? We were not, like, shocked, or we didn't have, like, that hype factor that much, just because we know he can do this stuff,
mm-hmm.
and for us it's just like, okay, normal, like, he a great guy doing great things, but still, like, if anybody else dropped this album, like, imagine how, like, impressed we would be with that person. Like, any, yeah. And so I still, it's still an amazing listen, and I know that I'll be listening to it a lot, and I'm curious to hear other people, like, analyzing this album and, like, giving it more meaning and, I mean, interpreting it their way, and so that it is accessible to us as well. Because I cannot really get much from just listening to this album. But, yeah, it would be really nice to hear all the analysis of this album. And it's definitely a legendary listen, a classic album for sure. Another addition to his catalog, and great visuals. And the visuals is important. The reason I'm kind of mentioning it more this time around is because I just came to realizing that visuals are very important, like, because without the album covers, like legendary album covers, for example, Kanye West album albums, without them, it's just like a pack of good songs. But, like, the album cover gives it, like, that color, that the atmosphere, that vibe. Man on the Moon 2, Kid Cudi, for example. Definitely great album, like, mood setter. And yeah, this album cover is also powerful, for sure.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely very intentional. I'm curious to see what it does with music videos.
Yeah.
To further, like, push that narrative, or that visual, but also, what is he gonna do as a single is the question, and we'll see what he really is intending.
I don't know.
What
we'll
is
see.
The first music video? Hard Part 5 had no music video, it was just him rapping with
the deepfake, yeah.
Which was terrifying,
yeah. But it was good,
yeah. But, like, what the fuck? Like, you could literally, like, be me,
yeah.
You could literally do whatever the fuck you want as me, and no one would know,
yeah,
unless you pay very fucking close attention. That's terrible. That's scary as fuck. But yeah, I wonder what he's gonna do. I mean, we know he'll do some crazy shit. So
yeah. All right. Thank you so much for watching. It was a great time. Hit the like button to subscribe. Hit the like button.
Hit the like button to subscribe. Subscription if you like the video.
Yes.
And we'll see you
in the next
one. Shout out to
Balur.
Jason Bourne.
No, shout out to Balur, new album coming out.
I can't shout out myself.
I'm shouting out the person that is in this room. No, I'm shouting out your alter ego.
Oh, okay. Balur. Yeah.
New album.
Not yet, bro. I haven't even announced the album.
Okay. Soon. Yeah, he's very bored. Soon. Keep waiting for the album.
Yeah.
Link in the description. All right. Well, to his singles.
Yeah, I got singles.
Yeah. All right. Bye, guys. Thank you so much.